This is the beginner's guide for modeling interiors in Blender. I'll show you how to create this bedroom and I'll give you some pretty important tips along the way. So let's get started. Move this default cube up so that it is on Z equals 0 level. This is to make it easier to add assets later. You can see the buttons I'm pressing on my keyboard down here. Change the dimensions of the cube over here. I'll increase the Z dimension in the edit mode like this. Otherwise, it would scale beyond the Z equals 0 level. To see the next steps better, let's move on to the wireframe mode. Add a loop cut in this direction to the middle of the cube, then move it along the X direction. That way, you can move the loop cut in measurable distances. Now, add 3 loop cuts in this direction. I have done this a couple of times. That's how I know exactly where to add loop cuts or by how much I have to move them. Select this edge and move it down like this. Add 2 loop cuts and move them towards this edge before placing them. Now place them here. Select this loop cut and move it in the opposite direction. Move this loop cut in this direction. I can adjust the movement over here precisely. Now move this loop cut in the opposite direction. In the face select mode, select this face and extrude away by 0.3 meters and delete the face. Now the basic modeling of that is done. By the way, do you have an attic in your house? I don't. That's one of the reasons why I'm making this in the first place. Add a new cube to the scene. Move it away and change the dimensions over here. In the edit mode, select this top face and press Shift, Ctrl, Alt and S to shear. Hit Y to shear on Y axis. Change the offset here. This is an angle but it is a tan value. We want this to be 22.5 degrees. So, tan 22.5 degrees equals 0.414 something. Select all and duplicate this and place it here. Let's shear the bottom face also from the same angle, but in the opposite direction. Select all the faces of this object and select this edge in the edge select mode. Now rotate this object around Z axis by 180 degrees. Then select the transform pivot point as active element. Now rotate the element by 135 degrees. This will be my timber structure to support the roof. This timber column and the beam are not made of a single timber block, so I need to replicate that. So let's keep some distance between these two. We can move this inside our attic now. Select all, move it up a bit and into the attic, like so. Select the top part and move it up. Go to the wireframe mode and then go to the X-ray mode to visualize this better. Move the top face in both X and Z directions by an equal amount. Now select the first object, duplicate it and move it away. Rotate the object on the Z axis by 180 degrees and then 90 degrees like this. Move it to the top like so. Move this face like this. Extrude it by this much. Extrude again and again. Select this face and extrude it down. This is our column. Select all and move it this way so it doesn't block our window. Now duplicate it and move it away like so. Select this face and this face. Hit F3 and search for bridge and press enter. Do the same for these two faces as well. Select these two faces and extrude like this. And extrude again so that you have faces to extrude as columns. Do the same for other side also, but I'm not going to extrude the columns down. Now modeling the room is finished. For the next steps, I'm going to move the camera inside the room. First, I'll rotate the camera. Hit 0 on the number pad to see the inside of the room. Our camera view right now is a bit narrow, so let me decrease the focal length. We can change this later. Move the camera a bit on the x-axis to see the room properly. I feel like these columns are too bulky. We can reduce the width like this. But I want to have the same width for this column. Let me extrude these faces like this. Right now, our window is just a hole, so we'll add a rail window using the Archimedes shadow. Rotate it 90 degrees around the Z axis. Change the other dimensions also. Rotate the rail window by 45 degrees and move it here. Before lighting the scene, I have to adjust the render settings. My workflow is cycles, so let's change the render settings accordingly. I prefer 32 samples in my viewport, and denoising should also start when samples reach 32. For initial renders, I like 128 samples. don't need this many light parts, so let me decrease it too. Now we can light up the scene. Go to World Properties. Click on this yellow dot next to Color. Select Environment Texture. Click this Open button and select an HDRI you have downloaded. Before going to the rendered view, select this camera view as the render region. Now go to the rendered view over here. I don't like the way it looks, but we can change it along the way. We need to change the rotation of the HDRI, so let's move to the Shading tab. I'll rearrange the windows like so. Select World as the shader type. This is our node setup for the environment. With this environment texture selected, press Ctrl plus T. But mind you, you have to have Node Wrangler add-on enabled to do so. Go back to the Layout tab, and now we can change the Z rotation of the HDRI. However, this HDRI seems to be having a dark and cloudy sky. I need a sunny HDRI. Hope this one would do the job. Increase the strength here up to about 5 so that the interior is properly lighted. Move down the HDRI along the Z axis. I don't want these trees to be seen through the window. Those trees in the HDRI doesn't blend with the rest of the scene, that's why. The next step is modeling the floor. So, let's set a cube. Change its dimensions appropriately. Go to the Modifiers tab and add an Array modifier. Change the factors like this. We need to have a little gap between two planks. Otherwise, it wouldn't be visible that we have more than one planks. Change the Z factor like so. Now, add a second Array modifier. Change the X and Y factors like this. Now, increase the count. Now we have a set of planks. We can add a third array to finalize our planks. Change X, Y and Z factors like this. Increase the count also. I used a duplicate of this plank set for my flooring. With that, we'll start adding materials to our bedroom. Select this plank set. Press Shift A and select Scale to apply the scale. In the Edit mode, select All and unwrap the object. You can select the cube projection. Do the same for the flooring as well. Let's shift to Shading tab and select Shader Type as Object. We'll use EasyBBR add-on to add materials. There you don't have to load each and every map by yourself. The add-on is going to do that for you. First, you have to load this library. Select Wood. We'll use this Wood 039. I have downloaded this material before, so I'll just press the plus button. Go to Material Properties. Now you can see the downloaded material here. To see this material, we'll go to the Look Dev mode. So we'll do the same for the wall planks as well. But we have one problem. All of the planks looks exactly the same. Let's fix that. Select one of these plank sets. In the Array modifier, we can change the UV offsets like this. Any value except 0 would work. But you can choose the one that works the best. Do the same for all these three array modifiers. With the change of all three UV offsets there, you can now see a random look in the planks, which make this look realistic. Do the same for the other plank set as well. Change the Z rotation in the mapping node and we are good to go. We'll add wall materials. Select these faces and in the add-on, select bricks. We'll use this brick 022. On default, the cube already has a white material. So we have to assign the materials for the selected faces. Couple of problems here. Let me unwrap the whole cube by selecting all, choosing Smart UV Project as the UV mapping type. Second problem is that these bricks are in the wrong faces. To show you what has happened, let's go to the face orientation in Viewport Overlays. Ideally, all the faces you see should be in blue, which shows the correct side of the face. Now we have to flip these red faces into blue. To do that, press Alt N. Choose Flip. Now uncheck the face orientation. We can add a hue saturation node here to make this brick wall a bit darker. We can increase the saturation also. Our brick seems a bit distorted. We can fix it in the mapping node, like this. Change the Y location of the bricks to make it look like the bricks are starting from the floor. To have correct proportions when modeling, we can use this model of a man who has real-life dimensions. Let's keep him here. We can now see that the dimensions for our bricks are not accurate. We'll adjust the scale of the map compared to the scale of the man. Here I haven't applied the scale to the room. That's why I have to use different scales for X, Y, and Z. We can apply the scale to this timber structure to avoid having to do custom scaling. Choose Smart UV Project when UV unwrapping and add this wood 004 texture. The displacement needs to be reduced. Reduce the strength of the normal map also. Then we can add the material for this wall as well as the slanted wall. Change the Z scaling as well as the Z rotation like this. I'll increase the darkness of this material too. Finally, add the same material for this window sill also. Adding materials is finished now. This is our attic up to now. Let's increase the strength of the HDRI a bit. Now that's better. The next step is furnishing or the interior design. The best way to start is developing a character who is going to live here. That's how we can have furniture that are complementing each other. This attic bedroom is for a couple who likes a functional and comfortable space for them to spend the night and the day. We are going to add furniture that are essential for them. For example, a comfortable king-size bed, a rug underneath, a nightstand, some flowers, and a floor lamp. This couple likes to read, so we'll add a whole reading area, a bookshelf, and a chair that both of them can curl with a good book, and few plants to connect the room with the nature. So, let's start adding them. I generally use 3dsky.com, which has a lot of free models of high quality. And I use 3D Warehouse too. And there are many other paid asset libraries you can use too. However, these are not blend files, so we have to import them. Go to File, Import, select the file type, locate your downloaded file. Depending on the file type, you might have to scale and load in materials. For example, this bed I just added is huge and we cannot even see it. Let's press number pad period key and see. Still no. Since the imported objects are already selected, let's hit S and 0.001. Oh, there you go. Rotate it by 90 degrees. However, I am going to delete these blankets on the top. I am going to use a blanket from a different bed. Go to edit mode, make a selection like this. Press Ctrl L and delete the vertices. So, this is the blanket we are going to use. Delete everything except for these blankets. Select the remaining part and move it onto our existing bed. Scale it as necessary. Next, we'll add a floor lamp to the bedside because we need to have some light if we are going to read a book on the bed at night. Every bed needs a bedside table. Next, we can add this rug underneath the bed. That is also an absolute necessity for a bed to be comfortable. Now we have to lift this bed a little bit. Sleeping area is done. Let's move on to the reading area. Let's switch to the look dev mode while we are doing all of this interior designing. Our reading area will be this corner. Now we need a little table to keep things like this. Having a rug underneath makes us feel comfortable. So we'll add one here. We need a wall lamp here, in case they want to read at night on the chair. The final item for the reading area is the bookshelf. You have to have a bookshelf if you are a reader. Now we can add final assets to complete our bedroom. First off, we need a main lamp for the room. And we need few plants too. Why three, you would ask? Having an odd number of things make the room a bit natural. 2, 4 or an even number may seem a little too organized and man-made. Let me move the camera a bit backward to see everything properly. Now we need some things to go on top of this bedside table. How about this book and the flower vase? Few fine adjustments. I'll move the table where the books are. And I'll move the plant a bit too. And over here, I'll add a couple of books and an artifact that looks like a bottle. I thought of adding an ottoman, which I think can come in handy for any bedroom. This little door would make it look like we have a wardrobe here. We can stop right here, but I'm going to add some stairs to the room so that the room is complete. I'll fast forward this process. You can slow it down if you want to. I added this fence also from the Archipack add-on. We need some bevels to these planks because they are very sharp. And in real life, no edge is this sharp. This fence and the stairs are blocking my view, so let me move it down for now. Let's go to the render view and see. That's not too bad. Here, on default, our contrast is a bit low. Let's change the contrast in render properties. Go to color management. There you can adjust the contrast. That is better, isn't it? Another way to improve this is by giving extra details, such as things in the environment. So right now, although we have a window, we don't see anything through that. But we can have a tree that is obstructing the sunlight and have a shadow that is casted on this wall. I'm using the botanic add-on to add a tree. I'll use this tree, which has a lot of details. This part is a bit tricky because you have to find the location of the sun as well as the direction of the sun rays. Let's move the tree up. Now it is perfectly working. I added these extra artifacts. Instead of just one, we have three. People sometimes call it the rule of three, where we don't have isolated things, like these artifacts or those plants. For textures and materials also, you can apply this rule of three. For example, we don't have too many colors that are popping up. We have only this flashy blanket of purple and pink. The rest of the colors have some similarities with each other. For example, look at the colors of these textures from walls, floors, and the timber structure. They are not the same, but all of them have some similarities in their color. By the way, these rugs have some bold patterns in them. You don't want too many patterns in a bedroom. That can sometimes be disturbing. So let me change this with some subtle patterns. I forgot to add bevels for these columns and beams. Let me quickly add those. Now let's give this a render. I added this laundry basket to give sort of an illusion that there is a wardrobe behind this door. I'm going to add a tree line backdrop so it would show that this house is located maybe near a forest. This is our tree line. Depending on the camera view, we might have to adjust the location and the scaling of the tree line. So, this is my final render. See, I have made some additional changes like changing the plants or changing the color of the headrest of the bed. That's how it is. You have to change things if they are not working. Now look how I have framed this shot. Focus of this bedroom is the bed, so it is in this particular point. When you overlay a 3x3 grid, the key here is to keep your focal element in this particular point in the 3x3 grid. Usually you get a better visual appeal when you frame it like this. And I have some sort of a foreground also, apart from the background. Another thing is I haven't tried to catch the complete plant on these edges. If I have caught the complete view of these plants or the ottoman through the camera, it would seem too organized and may look like I have deliberately placed these items just for the shot. So that's it for this video, guys. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Hit that like button if you enjoyed my content and subscribe me if you want to learn more about modeling interiors in Blender. So if you want to learn more about interior design tips, watch this video next.